can and can't do.
Oh, really? Says who?
Can't just change your rules for yourself. It wouldn't be fair.
Why should I listen to you, you silly little girl?
Enough. We're all friends here.
Like I said,
to the game.
I'm all in.
Fine, be that way. I fold. I pair of kings.
I was bluffing it the whole time. I tricked you.
I'm all in. I got 25 cents.
I call. I got a full house.
Wow, I can't believe I lost to the stupidest person I know. On top of that, a girl.
Don't be jealous of me just because I'm better than you.
I'm not jealous. Don't be ridiculous. I'm just a man, and that makes me better than you.
I'm sick of your sexist insults. I'll beat you at anything.
Good joke. Now hurry up and finish this stupid game. I never liked it anyways.
I raise $5.
I call and raise another 5.
I call it 10, and hey, what happens when you run out of chips?
You lose, you stupid girl.
At least I beat you, Jasper.
Whatever.
I call. I got 3 of the kind of sixes.
Sorry, Walker, but I got you beat. I have a straight.
That knocks me out of the game. You win again, Tex.
What a surprise. Tell me, Tex, when was the last time you lost?
You only lost once, and it wasn't to you, Jasper, because you're terrible.
Well, you're ugly, and no one likes you. How about you prove to me that you're not worthless?
And how would I do that?
By accepting my dare.
Okay.
Guys, I mean, girls and a guy, let's not let this get out of hand.
I dare you to go in the woods behind Tex's house.
Ha, piece of cake.
I wouldn't do it if I were you.
Yeah, me either.
Don't you know the story of these woods?
I know that story!
Long, long ago, there lived a noble farmer who used to grow his crops and ride into town to sell them for a profit. Although he was a good man, that farmer, his curiosity always tended to get him into trouble. On his way into town, he always rode past the same woods. The curiosity mounted inside of him each time he passed by the woods. Each time he rode by, he saw the same strange structure that led a little bit back into the woods. One day, on his way back from selling his goods in town, he decided to stop and go and see what that strange structure was.
So, the farmer ventured deeper and deeper and deeper into the woods, the dark, dense, yet seemingly harmless woods.
By the time the farmer had neared his destination, he had built up a sweat and the icy wind stung his neck. He began to get very uneasy about where he was.
The farmer finally reached the structure, which turned out to be an enormous, hollow, concrete tube. He decided to stick around for a while and survey the area.
The farmer walked back around and through the tube until he was satisfied. But when he turned to leave around, something grabbed him from behind and he let out a piercing scream. That was all he was
many theories that have come out of the story, the most popular of which is that there's a beast of some kind that lives near the tube.
No one who's ever gone to explore the tube has came back alive.
You guys are just lying to me to try to scare me.
Think what you want, but I don't think you're man enough to go into those woods.
I am a woman. I am strong. Anything you can do, I can do better.
I don't know. I don't think it's worth the risk.
I'm not afraid.
That's what you say now, but when it comes time to enter those woods, you'll chicken out.
It's up to you, Andrea. Do you really think you have the nerve to do it?
I'll do it.
Walker, Jasper, and I will come into the woods with you, and we'll follow along behind you.
You have to go into the tube, too, Andrea.
I think that little detail's gonna scare me. Let's get the show on the road.
Scared yet?
No way. And by the way, if I complete this dare, you're gonna have to do something for me, and it won't be as easy as this.
You don't scare me. I doubt you'll complete this dare anyway.
Whoa, guys. Take it easy.
Wish you could come on. We don't have all day here.
Scared yet?
No way.
Jasper, stop ripping on Andrea. She's your friend.
No, but you better stop giving me advice.
Yeah, dude, you should take some anger management classes.
Calm down.
Chill, dude.
Deep breaths.
Andrea, this is your last chance to back down. If you want to do it now.
she go?
Beats me.
She chickened out. I knew it.
Dude, she already completed the dare.
Well, yeah, you're right. Dang it.
Shh, guys, be quiet. I think I hear something.
Just don't fool yourself, Jasper. Don't be ridiculous.
Thank you.
That wasn't a compliment.
Yes, it was.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was!
Drop it, Tex. It's not worth it.
So what are we gonna do about this?
Nothing. Andrea's gone forever, and if we go back in there, we'll be mincemeat.
Get a hold of yourself, Walker. We have to do something about this. We can't just leave our friend to die. That is, if she's still alive. Which is highly unlikely at this point.
Let's have a moment of silence for our friend Andrea.
Nah.
Alright, now what are we gonna do about this menace?
Nothing, I mean, really. What can we do about it? We're just kids.
Walker, settle down. We need your brain power for this plan to work.
Yeah, he's right. We gotta pull ourselves together.
Alright, let's take down this monster.
Right. I think we should try and take the beast by surprise.
It's impossible. The beast is way too smart.
Yeah, we should stick together, because strength lies in numbers.
I think we should split up. That way one of us is bound to find the beast.
The object isn't to find the beast, it's to hunt it. We are supposed to be the hunters, not the hunted.
What is that supposed to mean?
Right.
Jasper's plan would get us all killed.
Yeah, if we stay together and it's absolutely necessary, we can split up, but only if it's necessary.
Fine.
Our only chance will be to catch him by surprise.
Yeah, we should sneak around the back of the tube and wait till we see him. Then we make our move.
That sounds like a good idea.
Alright, let's get going. We don't have all day.
This is such a good block!
Have you ever been camping in the woods
and felt terribly worn out?
Have you ever been camping in the woods?
And ran out of food?
Well, we've got good news for you.
Introducing Pig's Head on a Stick Energy Snacks and Drinks.
They come in many assorted flavors and forms.
So you don't have to eat unripe berries.
So buy Pig's Head on a Stick Energy Snacks and Drinks to avoid hunger and low energy levels.
Pig's Head on a Stick Energy Drinks and Snacks.
Available at your local grocery store.
Yeah. not good.
It's my conscience.
There's gotta be something.
I hear something.
We need to get out of here.
Just split up. We just gotta get out of here alive. Go, let's go. Police. What am I gonna do with the rest of my... Who's there?
Who...